Welcome back to Digital Marketing by Gina. My name is Gina Sentowich, and I'm a digital marketer that has worked as a consultant for agencies, for private companies, and I'm here to help you on your digital marketing journey in 2021. If you're new here, the goal of this channel is to inspire and empower those of you just starting out digital marketing and trying to get your foot in the door. After a previous video I did about how to make a digital marketing portfolio, a lot of you gave me feedback that you want to know how. Exactly what are the steps to make a digital marketing portfolio, especially if you want to apply for a job? That's another question that I've been receiving from a lot of you. So let's boil this really down and make it simple. If you cannot get that dream digital marketing job you're trying to get, let's get you a powerful digital marketing portfolio site to impress and wow those future employers. Today, I'll be walking you through a tutorial on how to make a portfolio website to get a digital marketing job. I also wanted to give a shout out to Wix. Thank you to Wix for sponsoring this video. I'm going to give a very thorough tutorial of how I made a portfolio website using Wix. Now, I know you want to get into the nitty-gritty and see the tutorial, but before we get into that, I wanted to mention a couple things. The first thing you need to do before you start building your portfolio website is you need to gather 3 digital marketing jobs you're interested in applying for. The reason is you need to be able to understand patterns of those jobs. Are there certain things all 3 postings are asking for in terms of skill sets, in terms of experience? That way we know to include that on your portfolio website. Also, remember, I have mentioned before that digital marketing jobs can be different depending on the company and what they're looking for. One digital marketing job could be very creative, focus on graphic design, focus on creation of ads, billboards, things of that nature. And another could be really technical, and it could be looking into front-end coding, Google Analytics, and a lot more of those analytical skill sets. So you really want to understand, what is the goal of this portfolio site? What are the things that I want to highlight so that I can attract the hiring manager and get an interview for these jobs? The second thing is, once you have those jobs and you're taking a look at the patterns across what skill sets are they asking for, experience, relevance, etc., then you need to start writing a bit of content. Now, this is an important step before you get into the website build because it will save you time. You need to think of how you want to present yourself on a portfolio website. What are the strengths you want to highlight? What are the impact statements you could supply and talk about? I did X at this company and this was the result. This is what I learned from that experience. Those will be really powerful in speaking to your portfolio website because we don't want it to have filler. We don't want it to feel generic. We want a really strong website that showcases you and tells your story of why you deserve those jobs. Now, without further ado, let's get right into it. Let's build a site step by step. The site will ask us questions to help us find the right theme. We're creating a portfolio website. So I'm going to search digital marketing portfolio. This will then show the features for the website. You can see chat, bookings, Instagram feed, events, but all we'll need is subscribe form. Then it asks, have you created a website before? We're going to choose, this is my first time, because I want to show you how to get your portfolio up and running. We're optimizing this process. But we still want to choose our own template, so I'll click that option. Now, this is the money section of Wix, the heart of it all. There are incredible templates for every type of business or creative project. As you can see, they have a different design from the font, colors, and overall aesthetic to even the flow of content. Now, I could spend hours going through these templates that are showing up for digital marketing portfolio, but you can also search any topic you'd like. Now, this theme catches my eye. It follows a portfolio structure, but I like how the design is sleek and clean while showcasing words in a storyteller manner. Now, first thing, quickly, I will change this text to my name. And in the text settings, we can also change the font size, make it bold, italicized, anything you'll want to customize.
This subheader I'll change to Digital Marketing Strategist, but change it to how you want to define yourself for a potential employer. Now, going back to our site menu on the top right, I'm actually going to change our CV page to be About and Blog to be Portfolio. That way I can include links to my work and be more comprehensive with discussing my job experience. However, if you want to start a blog, feel free to keep this page and just change CV to be Portfolio. I'm going to edit to make sure all of these fit within the menu. And if you want to make any changes to the menu layout, we can do that here. I'll delete these icons because I'm not creating a login section or any content you'd have to log in to see. Now I'll add the links to each of my social media accounts that I'd want someone to find to learn more about my skills as a digital marketer. So don't add personal accounts if you don't use them for professional or networking purposes. To go back to our homepage, we'll click the site pages icon. This left-hand menu is your best friend. It has all the customizers you would need. The plus icon is any element you want to add, from gallery to embed, where you could add a YouTube video, Instagram post, or a Spotify song, buttons to add calls to action. Now, the second icon, as we've seen, is site pages to direct you any point in the site. The next icon is our theme manager. So we still have control over the main colors and font of our theme. I'll show you the different aesthetic these colors can create. I'm personally more drawn to clean, crisp primary colors. This can make it easier to read. But if you want to change the background of a single website page, we can do that with the fourth icon. Next, in our app market, there are add-ons we can add for increased functionality. A popular one, especially for a portfolio website, would be MailChimp Forms. But you can see all the options here. I know a lot of my subscribers have mentioned they want to do Facebook ads. Media allows us to either upload media or use free Wix images. Last icon is blog. If you choose to create a blog, this is where you'll go to create posts. Now let's get back to our website. If you have a professional headshot or photo of yourself, feel free to add it to your website. What I love about portfolio websites is that they're very empowering. A resume or CV is such a simplified version of you. There are different opinions on including your photo on a resume, and in my personal experience, I found it was more challenging to get interviews. But for a portfolio website, we are telling a story, your story. So let's include a photo. But I do have a headshot, so I'll upload that from my computer. Once you upload, you can crop to make your photo fit the theme better, or my favorite, cut out the background. I'll make some edits to my photo, quick crop here, and there we go. Now, as I'm editing, I'm finding the background color is taking away from our content and overall storyteller feel. One of the best things about Wix in creating your personal portfolio website is just testing. Try different colors, play with different elements, and see what feels like it defines you. I like this light blue, so we're going to stick with that for now. But before you start building your website, you'll want to think of how to describe yourself and present your skill set. I have content I've created that I'm going to pull into this site. It has a focus on my skills as a certified paid media specialist. With a portfolio, you can showcase not only your experience, but you as a person. So I'll keep the flow of this template, but change this text to say a bit about me. I'll also add a quick animation on the text, which you can do for any element. Now, one of the things I love about this template is the flow. So in this paragraph, what are some special traits you have that are applicable to positions you're applying for? I have some content for this section taken from my LinkedIn. I'm going to add it here, but just give a quick edit. Always read everything over. And I'm going to actually bold the most important takeaway. So if someone skimmed only this homepage, this is what would stick out to them. We have our services highlighted here, very visual, very engaging. I'll just edit the skills that I want to promote. Now, if you are applying for a job, try to match these skills with the skills they ask for in the post. That makes it easier for hiring managers to find relevancy for the position and see you as a potential candidate. Now let's make this CTA more actionable, directing to our portfolio page instead. Now Wix has stunning stock photography, and I'm going to leverage some of that, which is free, with my account. I have the account for freelancers and entrepreneurs. Now for this section here, when you're thinking of content to have on the homepage, although this is a portfolio site, if someone only skims, we want them to walk away with a strong impression of your strengths and cultural fit. So considering that strategically, what I'm going to add here is the type of company I want to work for. Calling this out is not only impressive to a hiring manager, but it shows a level of ambition and self-awareness that companies appreciate. Now let's use this paragraph below to outline soft skills. Even if you don't have a lot of work experience, which I've heard from a lot of my subscribers, this is a great spot to discuss school projects, for example, a time you showed leadership. Or if you are self-taught, mention the research and independence you had in obtaining those skills on your own. Since we're focusing on those soft skills, let's make the CTA learn more about me and direct to the About page. Now, we have client collaborations and blog posts in this template. You can add logos of companies you've worked with or volunteered for, but if that's not applicable, just delete. Now, if you'd like to use this website as a blog, you can update this section after adding blog posts, but for my portfolio site, blog posts aren't necessary right now. I'll just delete. And that's my site. In 10 minutes, I've created the homepage for my portfolio website to find a digital marketing job. Once you've built the homepage, it gives you a great skeleton that you can build out from. But let's quickly go over About and Portfolio. We'll go back to Site Pages About. Now, this is an awesome template, so you can fill in this content and think of it as an extension of your resume. If we go back to the Portfolio page, though, this is where we tell our story. You can leave this as a blog, but I'm going to change this to portfolio because our goal of this site is to land that dream job. If we right click, I'll go to manage posts, and this will take us to the blog app within Wix. I'll delete this section over in site pages and duplicate to make portfolio. Now let's start building. I'll change this header and we'll use the same flow of the About page, but I want it to be immersive. So a powerful feature we're going to add at the very top above the fold is a testimonial slider. Go to Add, Interactive, and I'll add this yellow testimonial. This is powerful. It adds credibility and trust by having this here. To edit, I'll just click the text to add a testimonial. Now we can also change the slide background. You can choose between colors, images, or even a video. Uploading a video is the same process as when we uploaded our headshot image, but I'm going to keep it simple and just leave it green. The other two slides, we can also change the background and edit the text. For our sections on this page, think of them as your power case studies. I'll start with an impact statement with specific numerical stats because this adds credibility. If you don't have a specific stat, that's okay, but think of a statement that reflects the impact of your work. In the body, I'll post content I have ready. Again, I'm telling a story, the tasks I completed, the platforms I utilize, and any other details to tell the story of this project. Now, to link to a website, highlight and double-click the text. We'll go to the link icon in our text settings and add in a web page URL. Now, I want this to be immersive, so let's embed an element. Let's drag and drop the embed Facebook video. This adds a great visual focal point to draw the eye. Now click change video and we have our video settings. We'll add the URL from the Facebook page we are pulling the video from. Going down, it's good to have at least two sections of case studies. If you have more experience, aim for five. I'll give an example of an impact statement here if you don't have a numerical stat. For example, this will show how expansive the project was by giving detail, and in this I'm using the number of ads I set up. For the body text, I can use a similar format as before, or I'll show you another variation. We'll go to add, strip. I'm gonna drag and drop this four column strip. Here's another way to not only share your case study, but it's a very visual format to showcase your process as a digital marketer. I'll add our headers of each step in the process. Again, a great way to highlight impact and really round out the story for our portfolio website.
As I mentioned in the tutorial, you can keep this as a one-page website with just a homepage to really simplify, especially if you feel like you don't have enough work experience that you would just be adding filler in to add extra pages. We don't want to do that. But if you have things that you want to link to really detail the story of this project, that can be a school project, that can be a site you built by yourself. It does not need to be a full-time permanent job that you had. Anything that taught you those digital marketing skills, mention them and talk about them. So having a three-page website that includes a section for portfolio and about will allow you to go into more detail. So thoughtfully think of, what are those patterns across these job postings I've gathered? What are my strengths? And then what are the things I want to highlight based on that? Now, if you are ready to hit the ground running and build that portfolio website to get that digital marketing job you've been eyeing, just click the link in my description. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below, or you can also send me a direct message on LinkedIn, Twitter, or Instagram, and I'd be happy to help. My goal is to help you get that job in the door at a digital marketing company of your dreams. So I'm here to help you. I appreciate all the love and support. Please subscribe and like this video so we can continue to build this amazing, empowering digital marketing community. Thanks so much for watching.